Yes, you're right. This is a new low.
Welcome to Ms. Mojo, and today we're reflecting on Joey and why the Friends spinoff ultimately failed.
That was one of the worst things ever. And not just on TV.
Part 1, A Sure Thing. It's been 20 years since we bid farewell to Rachel, Ross, Monica, Chandler, Phoebe, and Joey. Of course, Joey returned months later in one of the most hyped spinoffs ever. Fast forward another 2 years, we said goodbye to Joey again after 2 seasons and 46 episodes.
I'm glad to be here with you guys, and I feel lucky that we're all here to share this with you. When I look around the room here, I know I got it good.
Joey wasn't the first disappointing spinoff on the heels of a colossal success. Joni Loves Chachi, The Brady Brides, and Gloria had even shorter runs. Where those failures were quickly forgotten, Joey remains the go-to example of an unnecessary spinoff.
Nailed it!
This makes sense, as Friends is one of the most streamed shows. Conversely, Joey currently isn't streaming anywhere, although nothing's stopping Warner Brothers Discovery from putting it on Max, aside from not wanting to remind people of its existence.
I saved you something.
There it is, you did it!
Kevin S. Bright recalls being under, quote, a tremendous amount of pressure for a show to succeed on a Friends level. Joey also promised to fill the void left behind by Frasier, which proved that a spinoff to an ensemble piece could be unique while staying faithful to its titular character.
For 11 years, you've heard me say, I'm listening. Well, you were listening too. And for that, I am eternally grateful.
Unfortunately, Joey was more like the Tortellis, the other Cheers spinoff. Despite the anticipation, it was clear early on that Joey wouldn't work. The original pilot leaked online, not receiving the best response.
You're married?
You didn't see the ring?
Yeah, I saw a ring, but it's not on your left hand.
Yeah, it is.
If you say so.
Little changed in the aired pilot, although Andrea Anders replaced Ashley Scott as Joey's neighbor-slash-love interest, Alex.
So listen, I know you're having a party tonight, so I just wanted to drop off a list of rules about noise and parking and stuff.
You know you're invited, right?
Oh, okay.
Reviews weren't enthusiastic, but Joey premiered with 18.55 million viewers, riding high on the success of the Friends finale's 52.5 million viewers.
It's just so amazing to be up here, finally getting recognized for my work. It really, really does feel good.
Joey also won the People's Choice Award for Favorite New Television Comedy, although its competition included the equally short-lived Complete Savages and Father of the Pride. Plus, winning a People's Choice Award isn't that hard.
And I want you to know I'm gonna vote as many times as it takes to save you.
That's really nice, but you're just one person. It's not gonna make a difference.
How do you think Win a Date with Tad Hamilton won the People's Choice Award for Best Picture?
While not a Friends-sized hit, Joey performed well enough to get a second season.
Wait, what?
Following a hiatus mid-season, NBC essentially set the show adrift, moving it to Tuesday nights against the unstoppable American Idol. The second season averaged 7.1 million viewers, but it soon hit a low of 4.1 million.
What? No, they did a spin-off. He's still playing Joey, but he's not doing so well.
Between the dismal ratings and Matt LeBlanc's high salary, the network cut their losses, canceling Joey in May 2006, with the final 8 episodes not even airing on NBC.
That's more applause than I got.
Part 2. New Friends, New Home, New Joey. Although NBC was determined to make a Friends spinoff, Joey wasn't even their first choice. Initially, a Rachel spinoff was discussed, but she was arguably already the main character, and Jennifer Aniston was more interested in pursuing a movie career.
We couldn't use that one because, you know, Maddie LeBlanc has a spinoff called Joey.
We're glad this spinoff didn't happen, as it would have drastically altered the Friends finale. Imagine if Rachel got on the plane and we ended on Ross crying in Phoebe's arms.
I really thought she'd stay.
I'm sorry.
While a Chandler and Monica spinoff was considered as well, Courtney Cox and Matthew Perry were ready to move on. On paper, a Joey spinoff made sense since he was the only friend who didn't get married or have kids by the show's conclusion. This also demonstrated why a Joey spinoff didn't make sense, however.
Canceled? Like, they're taking it off the air?
As his friends matured, Joey got progressively more childish.
What a strange kind of grown-up.
Not to the point the character grew annoying or unlikable. There were attempts to flesh out Joey, most notably his relationship with Rachel, and we know how that storyline turned out.
You know, I was only kidding.
If that relationship proved anything, it's that Joey didn't need further depth. He was eternally a big kid at heart, and that's what audiences liked about him.
Why, God, why? We're the deal. Let the others grow old, not me.
The spinoff made the mistake of forcing Joey to grow up. The premise alone is hard to swallow, with Joey moving to Hollywood after trying so hard to keep his friends together. Although the pilot explains why Joey gave change a chance, we never believe he would leave his friends in New York and rarely talk about them.
I am very, very happy today. My sister just married my best friend. I'm here with the woman I'm just crazy about.
Joey also changed, going from the life of the party to a more negative character.
No, no! Stupid, stupid, stupid!
I'm still here!
Hey, neighbor!
As Kevin S. Bright put it, quote, Joey was a womanizer, but we enjoyed his exploits. He was a solid friend, a guy you knew you could count on. Joey was deconstructed to be a guy who couldn't get a job, couldn't ask a girl out. He became a pathetic, mopey character. I felt he was moving in the wrong direction, but I was not heard.
Nobody talks like that, you moron! Plus, I'm totally wrong for this. Those actors outside had beards. Oh, quick, grow a beard!
What's more, Joey worked as part of an ensemble, but the spinoff left the glass 1/6 full. That's not to say Joey was the sole issue, as the supporting cast left much to be desired, despite attracting talented actors.
Thought you were absolutely fabulous.
They did?
They're huge fans.
They are?
But they're going in a different direction.
Hey!
Drea De Matteo played Joey's sister Gina, but we like to pretend Adriana got away from The Sopranos and entered witness protection. While De Matteo had good comedic timing, Gina got saddled with a lot of uncomfortable jokes about breast implants and giving birth at 14.
The hell do you think you're doing? Joey doesn't know we slept together.
What? You never told him after all these years? Your breasts always been like that?
Paolo Costanzo played her nerdy son Michael, who felt like the poor man's Ross. LeBlanc and Anders dated for several years in real life, but Joey and Alex were no Ross and Rachel.
The other night was a mistake, then. Well, I wish I made mistakes like that more often.
Yeah. Me too.
Miguel A. Nunez Jr.'s Zach, who was introduced in season 2, was also an underwhelming substitute for Chandler. Not even Jennifer Coolidge could save the show as Joey's agent Bobby.
I'm sorry, there was a long line here, so I stopped by the bar next door.
By the way, is Bobby related to Monica and Phoebe's friend Amanda?
Jimmy, how come
I was such a star in high school and I ended up such a huge failure? I guess high school and the real world are just different, you know? I don't have what it takes to make it out there.
There were a few doppelgangers in the Friendsverse, with Adam Goldberg going from playing Eddie to appearing as another character named Jimmy. Or maybe Eddie just stole someone else's identity. Aside from LeBlanc, the only actor to reprise their role was Robert Costanzo as Joey's father.
Let me just ask you one more question. You gotta know the answer to this one. What was my character's name on Days of Our Lives?
I'll get your mother on the phone.
None of the other main Friends cast members made guest appearances, although David Schwimmer directed 2 episodes. The showrunners wanted Joey to stand on its own, without relying on gimmicky guest spots, but the show never got out of its predecessor's shadow. In addition to pushing forward without 5 of the original stars, Joey was produced without Friends co-creators David Crane and Marta Kaufman. Scott Silveri and Shanna Goldberg-Meehan, who later married, took the reins on Joey.
How long ago did you sleep with Jimmy?
22 years ago.
And how old is Michael?
22 and 9 months.
Despite initially saying, oh God, no, to the idea of a spinoff, Kevin S. Bright came on as an executive producer. Bright didn't agree with every creative decision, but the network executives, studio, and other producers didn't listen.
Or he breaks up with you and you scare him away. That's why I had to quit the football team, the baseball team. I ended up having to do theater. Oh, so thanks.
LeBlanc acknowledged that Joey was doomed from the start, even if he can't complain about his $30 million payday. Looking back, is there anything redeemable?
Sorry I'm late. I had a congratulatory phone call from Stephen Hawking. An honor, sure, but just...
Well, it's fun seeing guest stars like Simon Helberg and Bob Odenkirk pop up a few years before they hit it big.
You know what? You go. I'm gonna stick around. My apartment doesn't have air conditioning.
Some of the setups are amusing in retrospect, like Joey saying the wrong name at an award show over a decade before Envelope Gate befell the Oscars.
Rishka Sekretopovich.
Overall, though, it's evident why so many call this the worst spinoff ever. Part 3. It was a good show, right? Joey signified the beginning of a dark era for NBC, which fell from first to fourth in the ratings. Conan O'Brien regularly pointed this out, and the ensuing Tonight Show fiasco did not help.
Fourth place, yeah. I don't know why they're so happy about it. I work here, it's not so funny. Late night's still number one!
Joey seemed to turn networks off from spinoffs in general. That's one reason NBC didn't move forward with a proposed Karen Walker show.
It seems like our sole purpose in life is just to serve Will and Grace.
Right? It's like, all people see when they look at us are the supporting players on the Will and Grace show.
Spinoffs weren't abandoned altogether, with Better Call Saul, Young Sheldon, and House of the Dragon being modern success stories. Yet spinoffs now proceed with more caution, not wanting to be the next Joey. After a 5-year break, LeBlanc returned to the spotlight, winning a Golden Globe for Episodes. Although LeBlanc played himself, he also played against type in a show with a cynical edge, taking various shots at Joey.
They have numbers and research.
Yeah, research said Joey was going to be a hit.
Joey
was terrific, many ways.
In a way, Episodes is what Joey should have been, a Hollywood satire with a familiar face, but a completely different tone. Of the six friends, a Phoebe spinoff might have shown promise given her complicated past and promising future with Mike.
I want one.
Oh yeah? Well, tell me which one. I'll try to slip it in my coat.
Seriously, you want to make one of those?
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications. Beyond the main cast, we could imagine spin-offs centered on Jack and Judy moving to Florida, Carol and Susan bringing up Ben, or Rachel's sister Amy becoming a baby stylist.
I am going to be a baby stylist. What?
That's not a thing!
How about a spinoff where Gunther spends all his money moving to Paris, later realizing Rachel never arrived? Based on Joey, though, maybe we should leave Friends as is. The creators don't want to undo the happy ending, and with Matthew Perry's passing, that's never been more true. Let's just pretend Joey returned to New York, reprised his role as Dr. Drake Ramore, and moved into the apartment over Monica and Chandler's garage.
Where's Joey?
I think he probably opened a sandwich shop in Venice Beach.
Do you think Joey is criminally underrated? Explain why in the comments.
I got nothing!
Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from Ms. Mojo. And be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.